We are going to review today's Sony Xperia E smartphone. Xperia E is an entry-level Android smartphone with ICS. It also received Jelly Bean update. Being a budget phone, it features a durable body, 1GHz processor and 512MB of RAM. At the time of purchase, the device comes with ICS 4.0.4, but via PC Companion, you can update that to Jelly Bean. We had made a separate video on that, which you can find in techinana.in video section. The device looked to be optimized with Android OS, which works really well, and the performance here is quite great. But sometimes when you use multiple applications at the same time, this device is a bit laggy. That is due to 512MB of RAM on it. The phone specification is, the front size has a 3.5-inch TFT screen. It is powered by 1GHz Qualcomm Snapdragon MSM7227A processor. The RAM, as I said, is 512MB only. The camera, there is a single camera on the back side, which is a 3.2MP camera with 4x digital zoom. The internal storage of this device is 4GB and the weight of this device is 115 grams. Xperia E comes loaded with some nice features like Timescape, Play Memory Online, HD voice quality, xCloud is a sound setting that gives you more better output on headphones and on speaker. It also comes with a Walkman, mobile data usage meter, music unlimited, etc. And of course the device has setting through which you can use this device with other Sony product like PC, PS3 and Bravia TV. The front part of this mobile features a 3.5 display screen, which offers a maximum resolution of 320 by 480, and it comes with a single 3.2 megapixel camera. There is no front camera on this device. Powered by 1GHz processor and 512MB of RAM, the device is quite optimized with Android OS and works well with application. While in terms of gaming and multimedia, this device is not having some great features here. It looks that Sony has concentrated more on the look of this device instead of its internal hardware configuration. You can see the look here. Compared to other large screen phones in the market that comes with 4.5-inch screen, the 3.5 TFT screen is not really good for watching videos. The resolution is also very low, which is 320 by 480. The video output is average on this device and the phone has a very small look, but the body is quite decent here. The front part, as you can see, has a screen here and there is a 3 capacitive buttons at the bottom. The resolution is enough for reading emails and messages here. Also, you can surf your Facebook account easily. You can see the screen output here. So this is the screen output of Xperia E. Compared to these, on large screen side you get more clarity just because of a better back panel. This phone is having only a TFT screen, while compared to this, IPS display are more brighter and vibrant here. The touch performance, as you can see, is quite smooth here. For multimedia and gaming, as I said before, the screen is not at all great. It is below average. While for app usage, for chatting and etc., the screen output is quite proper here. For application like WhatsApp and WeChat, you can see the output is quite enough. The phone features a simple design packed inside a rugged body with plastic material and a mixture of rubber coating on the back side. Just below the back panel lies the micro SD card slot and memory card slot. You can see that here, this is the micro card slot, this is the memory card slot, and this is the battery of this device. And this is the back panel of Xperia E. You can see it is very thin, but compared to other devices that I have tested, this is more powerful. So I can say that Xperia is having a rugged body compared to other devices. While on the right side lies two keys, among which one is the volume key on the top side and the second is a round power button. This is also the screen lock key. It is fairly visible on the side, and at the bottom we are having a dedicated camera key. On the left there is a single micro SD card slot, while on the top side there is a 3.5mm headphone jack. As I said, the Xperia is having a very limited camera features. This is the camera of Xperia E. You can see the screen output here. There are very few enhancement settings available. You can see that there are top four options available, among which one is for geotagging. This is the camera timer. This is to set the exposure level. And the last one is scene mode, where only two scene mode is available. One is night and second is sports. So this device is not having quite great output for camera quality. Also the image is not so great here. Due to low memory, the phone performance is a bit limited in terms of playing games and watching HD videos. RAM puts a major impact on application and gaming performance here. First, we'll test out the video and audio output of this device. This is a high definition video. This is also the maximum volume here. You can see the audio output is quite great here, but in terms of video, this device is not having some nice features. The video take time sometime when you try to skip them ahead when you are playing an HD video, while for regular video this device works quite fine. For multimedia, I will rate this device 6 out of 10, and for gaming 4 out of 10. Also for music, this is one of the best devices in the market. We'll also, just before testing the audio, we'll test out some gaming output here. I had installed some standard games here like Temple Run 2 and Angry Birds. Other HD games are not working on this. You can see that this kind of games work really well on this device, while you cannot expect much from gaming here. Now this is a bit heavy games. You can see the slow performance here already. The screen is lagging a bit. So you can see the lagging performance here. This is because of low RAM on it, and also this device is not having any kind of GPU here. So for gaming, this is not a great device. In terms of music, Xperia E is quite nice phone. It offers you a vibrant audio output. The dedicated audio application in this device is Walkman's. You can see the maximum speaker output here. This was a bit low due to XLoud. I had disabled XLoud here. This is an additional setting available in the settings panel. It enhanced the loudness of this device. When you tap on it, the audio output is increased to more than 60%. In this way, the speaker output is quite great here, but you can see there are no sound effects available on this. For headphones, the audio output is optimum. Walkman also offers you some additional option when you are playing an audio. You can see a small icon here. Now here you can see there are some set of different things that you can do with the audio here. You can simply find that the video of that music on YouTube. You can also get associated ringtone or the download of this same music from Play Now, or you can search about the artist info on Wikipedia. So these are some additional thing that helps you to find the information on the audio track you're playing. In terms of multimedia, Xperia E is a standard device that offers you basic features only, while for HD videos, as I said, it is a bit slow in output. While for regular videos it works fine, that is because of low RAM. The TFT screen here does not make you happy in terms of graphic output, and basic games like Angry Bird and Temple Run works fine on it. Xperia E comes with some useful pre-install application like Timescape. This is a widget which gives you real-time update about your Facebook notification. To add a timescape widget, you just have to hold the press on the screen for some time, and you have to go in the widget section, and you can see down below. This is the timescape widget. First one give you a real-time feed of whatever updates done on your wall. Second one show you update from your friends, and the third one is for sharing something. So you can see the two widgets here. This first one is the friends one. You can see the things posted updated by your friends on your Facebook wall. The update notification shows the number counting here. Below that gives you a live feed of your whatever activity going on Facebook. The second application is connected devices. This help you to stream your phone content to other devices. It works mostly with Sony devices or other device that support this feature. It is good for sharing your photos on bigger screen. The second one is smart connect that manages all other things that is connected with the mobile phone, for example a headset or a charger. You can create a set of events here. When you enable an event one, you after connecting the headphone, the phone automatically starts playing the music. Play Now and App Extra are two services by Sony that offers you some extra stuff like games, ringtone, sound, etc. Sony Slack also is the same kind of application which works, giving you some additional features here. It is like an app store for this device that offer you optimized application for Xperia E only. So you can find some games or application from this section directly, while instead of wasting your time on Google Play, you can see the app recommendation here. Whatever application or games mentioned in this section will work with this device. There is one more useful application available in Xperia E, which is called as Track ID. If you want to find any information about a song you are not aware about, you just have to open this application, you have to press the center button, and it will find the information related to song from the internet. For example, I am playing a music on this smartphone, and press this button. You can see how the Track ID just listened to the song that I played in another mobile and gave me the information about that audio details. I get lot of detail here, like the artist info, download, searching the same song on YouTube, finding a video of that song. So this is a very useful application for those who are looking for song
info.
One more application that are useful in this device that come in this pre-install is a file manager, which is called as a file commander application. It gives you a bit of animated output of your entire phone memory and external storage. And the second one is Update Center. This is a dedicated application by Sony that help you to update your application instantly from single place. While there are two more applications, which is Video Unlimited and Music Unlimited, that you can download from Google Play directly. It offers you an option to stream popular music video directly through your on the mobile device. Video Unlimited features a direct video streaming of popular TV shows, movie, and lot more stuff. Being an entry-level device, Xperia E is a good beginner's choice. The phone offers you a great design, simple look, Jelly Bean update, and overall, it has a long life.
Audio
battery life
is always a positive point
of all Sony devices. The headphone provided with this device offers a good sound output. It offers a clear music, and you can also get some additional settings on it. Application like WeChat, WhatsApp, etc. works very nice on it. On 2G connection, they are a bit slow, but when you are on Wi-Fi or on high-speed internet, you can see the output is quite great here. Nothing lags or freezes here. You can use one application at one time, but if you open multiple application, this system, this mobile simply freezes a lot. After having a new Jelly Bean update, the device performance is bit improved to some extent. If you are going to buy this device, you can simply connect it through PC Companion and run a new Jelly Bean update. The phone can perform much better if the RAM is increased to 1GB. Xperia E works on 1530mAh battery. The battery capacity offers you a standard 6 hours of talk time, but it goes well for the entire day if you are using internet also. As per my usage, the battery output is great here. While as per the specification on 2G and 3G, the battery output is 6 hours. After using this device, I will term it as a music phone. Those who are looking for a decent device with Jelly Bean and awesome music feature, then Xperia E is great for them. The cost of this device is ₹10,000. While at a price range of ₹12,000, we are having a many popular devices in the market that are offering quad core processor, fine screen and 8 megapixel camera. Compared to them, Xperia E is bit pricey here. I can recommend this device to those who are looking for a durable music phone, neither for multimedia nor for gaming. Smart connectivity is another great feature of this device. The positive point of this device is it has a great design, it has nice music feature. There are smart Sony applications which are useful. The negative aspect of this device is it has a poor gaming performance, the camera output is not so great and the display is also average. That's all for now. For more review, tutorial, news and updates on latest technology, visit techrina.in. Thank you. Have a nice day.